Lena?
Lunch.
Morning, Ronnie, my old mate. Stan. Partridge. One of your clients, remember? Second most promising new actor in 1966. Yeah, I was just calling to see what you got for me this morning. Yeah. No. Ah, no. Right, thanks. For nothing. Perhaps I should withdraw my talents from the profession. Let them stew in their own juice. Must be something else I can do. Some position of authority calling for initiative, charm, drive. It's not going to be my day. Oh, Cyril. Cyril. Not you, too. Assistant Fisheries Officer. Loot maker. Could I make a loot?
My God. Stanley! What happened last night? Did I say terrible things to him? Did I say worse things to him than he said to me? Should I be abject or angry? Oh, this is going to be one of those days.
Assistant town clerk, jig tool operative. Fact is, let's face it, I'm almost totally incompetent. I'll put it this way. My abilities just don't command a market.
You want to be near the light, do you?
No.
Of course you do. I'll put you in the window so you can see it.
Can you help me?
Not at my age.
All right, George. I'll deal with the humans. What can I do for you?
Tell me, do you do gardening?
I am actually a gardener, my love. This is a gardening shop. That is what we do here, oddly enough. Gardener.
I mean, can you do my garden?
Oh, certainly, yes, we do gardening. What is it you want? Landscaping? Ornamental pool, sun patio with canopy and Regency-style table and chairs for quiet sundowners? Simulated brook compete with water plants, miniature gazebo and plastic ducks? I can hire you a hermit.
I just need a tidy up.
You look pretty spick and span to me.
The garden.
I know.
It's rather a mess. There's only me there, you see.
Leave it to us. I'll drop round and cast the professional orbs on it, shall I?
If you would. It's 12 Eskerdale Road.
12 Eskerdale Road. Yes, about 6.
That'd be lovely.
My pleasure, my dear.
Oh, excuse me.
Is there anything I can do for you?
You? You're joking. Oh, yes. I've just lost my rubber plant.
It hasn't come in here.
A humorist is all I need.
I tried to spread a smile. Would you like to come round the back with me?
What for?
To to show you what I've got. George! You must have your plants well trained. Do they always come when you call? George, we're just going round the back. Look after the shop, will you? He may and he may not. This way.
You must have very low ceilings back there.
What, George? No, it's the gardening. He doesn't always bother to straighten up. He only has to get down there again. Anyhow, he doesn't like it all that much up here. He prefers it down there where his friends are.
Friends?
The vegetable kingdom. To him, plants are more human than people. He sees us the way we see nettles. This way. Now, what is it you're thinking of?
Well, it's like this, you see. I had this rubber plant. Do you mind if I sit down?
That's really for gnomes.
Yeah. I'll get up if one comes. I had this rubber plant, you see. Lena bought it for me in the first flush of... Lena's my... Anyway, got sick. Don't know what it was, some sort of wasting disease. Think it was the atmosphere in the flat got it down.
Oil stove?
Acrimony. You know. I wouldn't like to be a plant living in our flat. Stuck in a room with two warring humans. The air thick with resentment and flying plates.
I beg your pardon.
She murdered it, didn't she? I mean, she'd only stopped at the chicken casserole. At least the chicken was dead.
I'm sorry, you've lost me.
She threw it at me, the chicken. Missed as usual, hit the Dali. She's done it before. Serving supper like a tennis ball.
I suppose we all have to express ourselves.
Yeah, that's all very well, but to get up in the middle of the night and murder my plant...
How do you know she did?
Well, I didn't. It wasn't suicide.
So you want another rubber plant?
No, to remind me of the good times.
With the lady?
With the rubber plant. The great thing about plants is they don't expect you to communicate with them.
Yes, well, how about this? To you, £1.50.
Haven't you got anything smaller? Baby one?
Venus flytrap, sage keeping a spider.
What about this? That looks about my mark.
A blade of grass.
Ah, well, let's live dangerously. 130, you said?
140.
Pleasure to do business with you. Apart from paying.
He's obviously trying to get his own back on his mother. Smothering her with tea bags. Symbol of domestic servitude. He's so Freudian, it's almost funny.
Quick grow, this is it?
Rampant.
Poisonous?
No.
Good. The worst comes to the worst, I can live on it.
Well, I'd better get back to the shop before George starts selling the people to the plants.
Don't let me keep you. Shan't pinch anything.
Not while I'm here.
Another thing is, you see, there's a possibility I might have murdered her last night.
Hello, Lena Peartree here. I'm afraid I shan't be in today. No, I'm afraid I can't tell you why, not now you've asked. Mr. Pumfret, you surely must see that if I tell you the reason now, the implication will be that I assume that you don't value my maturity and sense of responsibility highly enough to assume that since I must have a perfectly good reason for not coming in today, there's no need for you to know what it is. You surely must understand that if that were my opinion of your opinion of me, it would be quite impossible for us to work together. No, please don't apologize. Goodbye. Men. Oh. Hello? I'd like to... No, I don't want to record a message. I want to speak to Dr. Lamb. I need some support. Oh, never mind. Tell your master. Oh, never mind. Machines.
Murdered?
Possibly.
But wouldn't you know?
The events of last night are a well-known blank.
What?
Well, we've got into this pattern, you see. We're locked in a recurrent syndrome of mutual destruction. The argument starts some night when there's nothing on the telly. Right, accusations fly. We break the seal on the bottle of scotch we usually keep for friends, get blind drunk, start throwing things. Well, she does. Staffordshire figures, chicken casseroles, anything not screwed down. I get in the corner in the fetal position to cover the vulnerable parts. Are they all clear? Fragile armistice? I'm sorry. No, I'm sorry. No, I'm sorrier than you are. She cries, goes to bed. I cry, go to bed. We make love as best we can. Sleep it off in each other's arms and tidy up next morning.
Sounds a workable arrangement.
So sadomasochism.
Have you considered divorce?
No.
Catholic?
Not married.
That is a problem.
Only this morning, two things were different. One, she'd slain my rubber plant. Two, she was lying there with a pillow over her face. She was due in at work at 10. What am I going to live on?
You know what I'd do? Take her back some flowers.
Lilies.
You're not a violent man.
I am inside.
Murder is outside.
So you think it's just wishful thinking?
Take her back some flowers. They're a great weapon. I know about these things. I'm not just a pretty face. I used to be a solicitor. Marriage cases, ho-ho, I can tell you. The well-timed bunch of flowers lost me a lot of business. Where have you gone? Good morning. I'm afraid we don't do repairs.
I want another rubber plant.
We don't do part exchange either.
I want one this size.
With foliage?
Naturally.
You've had a spot of trouble, haven't you? Listen, my dear, I hope you won't only look on me as your nurseryman.
What?
We're all set on this world together, so if there's something I think I can do for you, we shouldn't stand on ceremony.
What the hell are you suggesting?
It's all right. Here's a nice, healthy one, and look, I think it likes you.
It'll do. They all look alike to me.
But not to another rubber plant. Bit of domestic trouble, was there? Trouble with the boyfriend? A bit too much to drink, perhaps. A touch of violence on your part. I'm not passing judgment. Men can be despicable, but in a final fit of justifiable rage, you killed his rubber plant.
Rubbish.
It's all right, my dear. Look on me as an uncle.
One of my uncles once tried to seduce me. One of my uncles, what am I saying?
It's all right, my love, I'm a happily married man.
So was he, till Auntie learnt what was going on.
Now you've decided on a placatory gesture, very wise. He'll probably bring you back some flowers. You'll fall into each other's arms, you'll cook him a nice chicken casserole, watch a bit of telly together, and then...
Do I know you?
We're all members one of another, my dear. No, actually, I only opened up here last week. I used to live in Sutton, stockbroker belt. Keeping up the image, not my place, really. They ostracized me for wearing gumboots on a Sunday.
He did it himself.
What?
He broke it. He was really attacking my love for him. He's so Freudian, it's pathetic. An empty gesture anyway, it was dead already.
Your love or the plant?
The plant?
Not quite.
All right, it was euthanasia. Then he covered a nude with wet tea bags and left.
He'll be back. Did he take his other suit? They always do in desertions.
He hasn't got another suit.
Fishing tackle, stamp collection, what was he attached to?
Nothing. He hasn't got anything. He doesn't do anything. He isn't anything. He's just a propertyless layabout.
Well, that's something. And there was the plant.
He wouldn't take the corpse, would he?
So why do you want another? To remind you of him?
I want to put it in the window for him.
Like a candle?
That's right. He'll be slouching by one night in the rain after he's been thrown out by whoever's foolish enough to have him next, and he'll see it there, like a beckoning finger. He'll stand in the doorway, ears down, like a dog that's been put outside for doing a mess on the carpet. And I'll throw it at his head.
£2.50.
It'll be worth it. Why am I telling you all this?
I'm the understanding type.
Oh, I better go back and clear up the mess, I suppose.
Need anything else, do you? Flowers? Cacti? Put one on his seat.
As for flowers, he hasn't bought me one of those since they stopped giving them away with packets of detergent.
You were saying?
Oh, she's right, you know. I treat her badly. She treats me badly, too. She really needs a stable personality to look after her. She's father fixated, you know, and I make a very sorry father figure. Anyway, she hated her father. Said he once tried to seduce her. Mind you, she said everyone once tried to seduce her. She had a pillar to post-adolescence, if what she says is true. But a lying bitch. Would I murder my own rubber plant?
She has bought you a new one. It's a nice gesture.
As a missile?
I have a nice selection of flowers in the shop.
No, you can't throw flowers. I'll give her this. I can't cope with two plants. You don't think it's too masculine, do you?
Not nowadays. Oh. Well, I'm off over the road for my midday drink. Business hasn't been so good over there, so I tried to help them out.
Oh, I'll give you a hand.
Just a minute.
What's that all about?
Try to creep over unnoticed. It never works. Prosciutto vegetable, he's very fond of his beer.
Come on. What about the shop?
They're 78.
Oh, they won't take much. They're a nice lot around here. Sometimes they even leave the money. Of course, the next one in takes it.
Yes!
George, fancy seeing you here. George, this here is,
I have a stout, thanks.
Allow me. What'll it be?
Oh, I'll have a large scotch. Very kind of you.
Yeah, it is, isn't it? Not to say foolish.
Well, George, you got those tomatoes potted up?
Lots of people throw them away when they finish their own.
What, George?
There's nothing better than the inside of a toilet roll for putting round your celery.
Yes, George, you tell me.
As it grows up, you hitch up another one on top and earth.
I'll bear that in mind.
It keeps it clean. And plant your peas inside the roll. Keeps the mice off.
They'll eat through them, George.
Cut them up into small pots for the seedlings. Start collecting them in the autumn. Ask all your friends.
People want a quiet drink, George. George is thinking of writing a gardening book. At the moment, he's on 100 things you can do with the inside of a toilet roll.
Put toilet paper around it.
101.
Oh, they've only given me a single. Do you want some water in it?
Don't bother. I'll get the next round while I'm up.
Cheers.
Kitchen rolls are useful too. You can pot on from a toilet roll to a kitchen roll.
I can see we're going to get on famously.
Hello? Dr. Lamb. Yes, I did ring. I spoke to your robot. Yes, I know I'm going to see you tomorrow. I just thought you ought to know that Stanley was up this morning covering the page 3 nude with wet tea bags. And I woke up with a pillow over my face. A dry pillow, but obviously there's a connection. So if I'm not in to see you tomorrow, perhaps you'll call the police. And you can take your fee out of my estate. Dr. Lamb, I'd love to work this out with Stanley in an adult fashion, if he were but an adult.
Can I have your glasses, please, gentlemen? Come on.
I've seen you before, haven't I?
I came in the shop.
Before then.
Zedgars, 68, played a villain?
No.
I did a biscuit commercial a couple of months back.
Might have been that.
Well, only the teeth, really. Biscuits had the starring role. I was more of a bit player.
You bit the biscuits.
Exactly. So it was a day's work and as many crummy bitelets as I could cram down me.
What was the name?
Crummy bitelets.
No, yours.
Oh, Partridge, Stanley Partridge, as in the bird.
Paisley, Dingley Paisley, as in the... pullover.
And the Dell.
Dell?
Dingley Dell. Literary illusion, Pickwick Papers.
I'm not really a reading man, more a student of life. Life's more interesting, you know.
Well, it's all right if you like that sort of thing.
I take it you're not a religious man.
Oh, I am. I believe in a malignant deity that's got it in for me personally.
You know what your trouble is, specialization. You're a one-job man, it's a curse of the age. Of course you get despondent, you're in a rut. Why be an out-of-work actor all the time?
What, you mean I could be a part-time out-of-work actor? Yeah. I have to be available, you see.
What for?
Work.
You said there isn't any.
Well, I still have to be available for it.
That could be arranged.
It's nothing illegal, is it? I'm not doing anything illegal, not since that Zed cars. They all said I was too obvious.
Nothing like that. No, no, a nice open-air job. Useful, interesting, productive.
I could be productive.
Come along, please. It's long past time.
Come over to the shop and we'll talk about it. George!
Hang on. I hate waste.
Come on, George.
A mixture of bone meal and dried blood and sprinkled gently round.
No, don't worry, George. You've got years ahead of you. Yeah, come on, it's lunchtime.
Throwing out time?
Why do you keep him?
He's not a commodity, he's a human being.
Is he?
You shouldn't be so intolerant. It's one of the great vices. Accept people as they are.
By that token, you should accept the fact that I'm intolerant.
He's my father-in-law, as a matter of fact.
Is he?
They say he's got a shoebox full of sovereigns somewhere.
I see your point. Poor old chap.
It's just that he doesn't reckon people. Maybe he was a plant in a previous existence.
Not a busy Lizzie, that's for sure.
What about my idea? Come in as a partner.
You're offering me a partnership, a man you've never met before.
I trust my judgment. You're decent enough underneath. Dig down far enough. Look, it's quite simple. You put £1,000 into the firm.
I haven't got 1,000 peanuts. Oh, that reminds me. My contribution to lunch. Excuse the fluff.
Look, you don't have to put any capital in. You work it off.
Wait a minute. You're giving me a chance to work for you for nothing.
Not for me. For the firm. Our firm.
For nothing.
It's an investment.
What am I supposed to live on if I plough all my earnings back in?
What do you live on now?
Dole.
Well,
I can't draw the dole if I'm working.
Only part-time.
No, it's not how long you work, it's how much you earn.
But you won't be earning anything, will you?
Wait a minute, that must be unethical.
You mean you're afraid you'll get caught?
Well, with my luck, I'll end up doing the garden for the dole clock.
Well, in any case, what about the lady she works?
Are you suggesting I live off Lena?
Don't you?
Only board and lodging.
Well, it's up to you. I'm making you a unique offer.
Wait a minute, wait a minute. If I'm a partner, I share in the profits.
That's right. When they accrue.
What, you mean this firm I'm buying my way into doesn't make any profit?
Well, we've got to nurse the business, haven't we? Plough the money back, build up stocks. Come on, what have you got to lose?
Sweat.
It'll do you good.
It's a big step, you know. It amounts to me becoming a useful member of the community. Ah, well. We better drink to it.
You won't regret it. Some of the customers might. Start next week.
Tonight?
Tonight?
Yeah, we've got to go around and see that lady's garden.
I can do that.
No, no, no. Start as you mean to go on. I wouldn't dream of it. To the firm.
To the firm.
What's it called?
Paisley Limited.
Yeah, I won't do. Partridge and Paisley.
Paisley and Partridge?
But aren't the two varieties in the same bed? Together, they make a lovely pair of bloomers.
Bloomers?
Knickers.
No, 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 no. Bloom.
I like it, Dingley. I like it.
Bloomers.
Well, I must get back to my loved one. You won't be needing these, will you?
Remember what I said. Forget the old grudges. Start afresh.
I'll play it by ear. If she's got a record on, I'll know where I stand. Chopin, Schubert, a moment drive. I'll meet you in the pub at opening time. That'll give us time for a quick one before we go round and see the lady. So long, partner.
I wonder if I've done the right thing.
My God, the lever's stuck.
Stanley, you are a despicable swine.
I know.
Then why don't you do something about it?
I shall. I shall. I've been a fool, Lena. I know that now. If you knew how I tortured myself while I've been away. God, I thought, if I could only have my time again. But the past is over, finished, finito. I'll make it up to you, Lena. If you'll just give me another chance. From now on, I'm going straight.
Not your Z-car's bit again.
Thank you.